had to delay the credentials by a day, given the outcome of the report on KwaZulu-Natal and the Free State and also Bojanala region in the West. That the issues there, we have decided that the PECs of KZN and Free State, those who are not branch delegates already, would not be become voting delegates so that they comply with the judgment of the vote. 30 or 35 branches of the Northwest were also disqualified as voting delegates. And you will understand that that takes a bit of work because you also have to explain to the branches why they were disqualified and these are court order and that withdrawing their delegation status. So all those people had to be converted into non-voting delegates. They could participate, but they're not going to be able to vote. Similarly, with the Free State, PEC members who are not branch delegates are also non-voting delegates, as are 14 branches who have fairly substantial delegations. So that did create a difficulty. However, we managed it. And we reported that to the committee and it was accepted. The branches have been withdrawn. We've also withdrawn categories of delegations across the board of people who did not pass what we call a verification process, which is a process of ensuring that indeed there was a BGM, a branch general meeting that sat, and that indeed had elected a delegation. And few people from that category have also been disqualified. There was also a find that about was mainly Eastern Cape and also Western Cape, small numbers of people would be left out by the state, two branches. They were disqualified by the verification process. We found they came, they appealed, found all the documentation, they were able to provide proof, and they were reinstated. So, you know, credentials is not just about nodding your head, it's about actually checking very thoroughly who the credentials are and what they're about, and that's what we were doing. There was no inflation whatsoever of the numbers. I really honestly sorry have to say that I've been reading all of this every day and I've been wondering where this is coming from. However, let me pass that note. In fact, instead of having the component of voting delegates, which would have been over 5,000 branch delegates, including your PECs, your leagues, would have been over 5,000, we now stand at approximately 4,700. So it's lower than the number that should have been there to vote. That's what the implications are. The point that I do want to make to you is that it's not unusual to delay credentials. We do it for the credibility of the process so that, as you well know, this is the one point that people use to have court interdicts and court cases and injunctions. And we've been extremely careful not to open any possibility that would take us in that direction. So, what, number one, stay true to the branch mandated delegates, and that's what we wanted to prove, and we have, to 90% of the case. The other percentage, of course, is what the courts did compel us to remove branch delegates, and we're living with that.